सर्वोदय नमस्कार, इट इज महेश हियर। इन टुडेज वीडियोस आई एम गोइंग टू टीच इंग्लिश ग्रामर फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 7 चैप्टर नंबर फर्स्ट द सेंटेंसेस। आई होप यू हैव ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड इन प्रीवियस क्लास अबाउट दिस लेसन अबाउट द सेंटेंस एंड इट्स काइंड टू लेट अस बिगिन वंस अगेन about the sentence. Let's focus on the word about the definition of the sentences. According to the definition of sentence, it is a sentence. It is a group of words. A group of words that arranged in order to make complete sense. Complete sense. It is a group of words that arranged in order to make complete sense is called a sentence. In other language, we can say that a single word can also make a complete sense, and it's also called a sentence or a word can also make a complete sense and it's called sentence. Any type of group of words that can be arranged or managed in a very good manner that can give a very good sense and we can understand the meaning of the sentence, then we can say that this is the group of words that is sentence. Now, I am going to give you some examples. From that example, you can understand very well. Look at here. According to the definition, a sentence is a group of words that makes a complete sense. Here, an example. I am going to write, Ram is a boy. Ram is a boy. The sentence that is arranged in a very good manner and it can give a sense and we can understand what the sentence is giving, what the sense of the sentence is giving to us. We can understand, that is why this is called a sentence. But if according to the word of this sentence, if we unjumbled the sentence, then it cannot make a complete sense. Look at here. Boy Ram A is. Here you can see the same word. But this sentence is giving a complete meaning, a complete sentence. That is why it is called a sentence. But this is also a group of word, but it cannot give a sense, it cannot give a complete meaning. That is why we cannot say that it is a sentence. It is not a sentence, it is a wrong sentence. And another example, he is a doctor. The sentence is arranged in a very good manner and it is giving a sense of that he is a doctor and we can understand the meaning of the sentence. But if we will jumble this sentence like that, Doctor A is he. Here is also the same sentence, same word, but this sentence is not giving a complete meaning. That is why we can say that this is not a sentence. And it is giving a complete sense. That is why we can say that it is a sentence. After explaining the definition of the sentence, I'm going to tell you about the kinds of sentences. Now, as I have told you that a single word can also make a sense and it is also called a sentence. I'm going to an example. Look at here. Here is a word. Go. Go. It is a single word, but it is giving also a very good sense and we can understand it. If somebody asks, may I go? Here is a question. May I go? The answer, go. In a single word, the answer of this question can be given. And that is where we can say that it is also a sentence. When there is a full stop after go, then we can say that it is a sentence. If there is no any full stop, we cannot say that it is a word, but only a word. Okay? Look at. After the definition and explanation of sentence, I'm going to tell you about the kinds of sentence. Focus on the board, please. We have to study 5 types of kind in English language. 5 types. 5 types. Number 1, there are 5 types of sentences. The first one, assertive sentence. The second one, assertive interrogative sentence. The third one, imperative sentence. Fourth one, optative sentence. The fifth one, exclamatory. You are looking at the board and you can see and observe by yourself that there are 5 kinds of sentence. The first one, assertive. Second one, interrogative. Third one, imperative. Fourth one, optative. And fifth one, exclamatory sentence. I am going to explain about the 5 kinds of the sentence in detail. Before going to detail, I am telling you, there is assertive sentence and it has also 2 part. It has also 2 part. It means assertive sentence has 2 kinds. Number 1. Positive sentence or negative sentence. The sentence that is in form of yes is called positive, and the sentence is in the form of negative, no, it means it is related to negative sentence. Then after, I am going to tell you the definition of assertive sentence. See, what is an assertive sentence? According to the definition, an assertive sentence that give a statement in the form of possession and negation. The sentence that gives an statement in the form of yes or no. Yes or no, it means he is a doctor. The sentence is in the form of yes. He is not a doctor. This sentence belongs to negation. It means the sentence is telling that the man is not a doctor. Getting it? Let us begin the next. The sentence that state something, state or declare something in the form of yes or no is called assertive sentence. Assertive sentence. An example. You are a student. Yes, Paul. And you are not a student. No, Paul. It means in the form of yes, the sentence is assertive or declarative too. Here you can see in the form of negative. It means the sentence is negative. You can say in the form of negative sentence, assertive sentence, and declarative too. The next one, I'm going to tell you the definition of the next one. That was interrogative sentence. The interrogative sentence that is used to ask a question to somebody. The sentence that can be used for asking something is called an interrogative sentence. It always begins with a capital letter and ends with a question mark. Look at the both. Kinds of two interrogative sentence. The sentence that is used to ask a question. It always starts with a capital letter and ends with a question mark. Question mark. Example. Are you a teacher? Okay. You can see the sentence starts with a capital letter and ends with a question mark. It means somebody is asking you or asking me, are you a teacher? Then the question will be, yes, I am a teacher. If I am not a teacher, I will tell no, I am not a teacher. Now an imperative sentence, I am going to write the definition of the present point. The sentence that give order or instructions. Order or instructions. And make a request, an event, offer, and even offer an advice. Are called imperative sentences. the sentence that give order or instruction, and even make a request, and even offer an advice are called imperative sentences. I'm going to give you some example. Please buy me a pen. Please buy me a pen. The sentence is requesting somebody. The sentence is requesting somebody to buy him a pen. And according to the definition, the sentence that used to make a request is called an imperative sentence. In other words, an imperative sentence, when you look at the book and you have to speak or write, you can observe that an imperative sentence has no subject. The subject of the sentence is always hidden. Like in the class, some student, a teacher asked to a student to close the book, to open the book. Hey student, open the book, close the book, shut your mouth, get up, stand up. This type of sentence that has no subject. And when a subject has, when a sentence has no subject and it asks about an order, an instructions, a request, an advice are called imperative sentences. After the definition of imperative, I'm going to now I'm telling you the definition of an optative sentence. The sentence that is used to give a cause or blemish is called an optative sentence. Example, the sentence that is used to give a curse or blame to somebody. It means some inner person that give us blame, that beta leave you long. May God bless you. This type of sentence that always used with may. May here. May you live long. And at the last of sentence, there is no any full stop, but a mark of exclamation has to put. Then it is the sentence of an optative sentence. If we don't put an exclamation mark but a full stop, we cannot say that it is a sentence from an optative. Otherwise, remember, always we have to put a mark of exclamation at the last of an optative sentence. It always start with may. Remember, the sentence is giving somebody a blessing. After this, I'm telling you an example about a curse. May God leave you long. May God leave you long. Bhagwan tumhe lambi aayu de. Bhagwan tumhe lambi umr de. The sentence is giving a bless to somebody, and it is starting from may and ends with the exclamation mark. At the last times of five, an exclamatory sentence I have written the definition that an exclamatory sentence that is used to communicate strong feeling of surprise, admiration, appreciation, wonder and shock. It means something that can be surprising to our eyes or mind. It gives some certain feeling, emotion into the mind. The sentence that gives us some strong sudden feeling or emotion into the mind, that is called an exclamatory sentence. In our regular life, we can observe that if me or anybody that can see something strange or something wonder around him or her, he got a surprise. What a beautiful lady this is. What a long man that was. What a beautiful sight this is. How lame this man was. And this type of sentence that give us some strong feeling emotion into the mind. And it also start with a capital letter and ends with a mark of exclamation. Mark of exclamation. It means here you can see an example. What an intelligent child he is. Mark of exclamation. What an intelligent child he is. You can see the sentence starts with a capital letter and ends with a mark of exclamation. That is an exclamatory sentence. I'm going to stop this lesson right now. In the next video, I will teach you about the phrase and the clause. Goodbye, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.